Something has happened to Martha. We need to speak with Otto.
What do we know, Otto?
Some lads from the Imperial garrison in Rosaria started a fight over at Martha's Rest. Blood was spilled, bones were broken. The usual. But somewhere in the middle of it all, Martha vanished without a word to anyone. And that ain't like her, Clive. Something's not right.
You think this was planned?
Of course it bloody was. Ever since Eastpool, the Empire's been tightening its grip around the Duchy's balls. They've strung up everyone who's ever set eyes on a runaway, claiming they're traitors to the Holy Throne, conspiring to restore the House of Rosfield to power. And now it sounds like the bastards have turned their attentions to the poor bearers meek enough to stay put. Naturally, old Martha could see the way the wind was blowing, complained that it was getting harder and harder to take bearers in.
And now she's missing. If she's fallen into the hands of the Empire, we could be next.
Couple of curse breakers are already on their way to the inn. They should help speed up the search. But if this is as bad as I think it is, you might end up having to save their asses and all.
Don't worry, Otto. I'll make sure everyone gets home safe.
Martha is a survivor. We'll find her.
Ah, my favorite pupil. How may I help you today? Of course. Here you are. The state of the realm is ever-changing, Clive.
Damn blighted bilge.
Is everything all right?
Aside from the holes in my hull,
everything's roses.
The lake water doesn't agree with it, then?
That's one way of putting it. And unless you got some grand scheme to suck the black from the lake like we do in the atrium, that slurry will keep eating away at the timber like young Tech does our lemon tarts. Suppose a coat of pitch might stave off the rot for a moon or so. Assuming we had any pitch, which we don't. Not any bloody more. Doubt the old tub's got more than a dozen runs left in him.
Of course, Obelus. Your skiff is our only means of reaching the mainland. Without it, we'd be lost.
Well, I'm glad someone round here sees it that way. To make pitch, you need pitch trees. But in case you haven't noticed, live trees are one of the thousand things sorely lacking in the Deadlands. Now, I'm not so unkind as to ask you to fell a faraway forest and lug the logs back here to the mere. Which is why we'll be needing a suitable alternative. And it just so happens I once heard the thorny pitchers of Curltail Falls cover themselves in a sticky wax to trap birds and beetles and whatnot. Might be enough to tide me over.
Sounds easier than felling a faraway forest, that's for certain.
Never been to Curltail Falls myself. Never seen a curl, for that matter. Not that I want to. I heard they'll tear a man from cock to crown soon as look at him. Good thing all we need is some wax from a thorny pitcher. How hard can that be,
easier than felling a forest, I said. Trees don't have teeth.
Finished.
Can't imagine Obelus needing any more than this. Time to head home.
What happened here?
Come on. We need to find the others.
Fucking Imperials.
If they are north, they have the old rest to answer to.
What was all the screaming and shouting, Mummy?
I told you to stay inside.
Any of you hurt?
No, they didn't come this way, thank the Founder.
Good to see you, Sid. The soldiers who did this are long gone, I'm afraid. We're doing what we can to treat the wounded.
What?
Anything catch your eye? Thanks very much. There you go. Fairly well.
Let's get you to a physical, shall we?
I'm sorry. I think I twisted something.
Sid? What said you'd be coming?
I trust you don't mind. Also thought you might need some help. And it appears he was right.
You could say that, yes. They're saying the Imperials ascended like a storm. No one was spared their fury. Martha tried to step in and calm things down, but all our efforts got her were a pair of iron shackles and a hard march.
Any idea where?
Judging by their tracks, they headed towards Sorrowwise Bay.
To the Abbey, sheltering Martha's bearers.
The bastards. Jill and I will go after them. You take care of the people here.
We will. But, before you go, one of the locals heard something. He said the soldiers were talking about a culling. I don't know how big this is, but it doesn't sound good. Be careful out there, Sid.
You do the same.
Lads from the garrison all poured in, swords swinging, and took Martha away with them.
This culling business. You don't think the Empire means to rid the land of bearers, do you?
Oh, Phil, you're making it worse.
Cole is right. That was no tavern brawl. It was a message.
But a culling? Bearers are the property of the Empire. The garrison wouldn't have the authority to act alone. The orders would have had to have come from higher up.
They've killed my bearer. I demand recompense.
And they call themselves our countrymen.
Thank you.
those Orsons touch air on Martha's head. I'll kill them all myself.
At the Abbey who need you. You have to do something.
Tell us what happened.
What happened? The damn Black Shields, that's what happened.
The Black Shields?
The bastards caught wind. The Abbot and I were helping bearers. They were gonna hang us both. When the sick rose from their beds, poor souls turned on the Imperials. Distracted them long enough for me to get away.
Then they may still be alive. Martha, do you think you can make it back to the inn? Cole is there with the other curse breakers.
I think so. Thank you, Clive.
Black Shield. Is this some sort of twisted joke? There has only ever been one Order of Shields in Rosaria, and they fought to defend all her citizens.
It seems a step too far, even for the Empire. Are we too late?
There might still be someone inside.
No.
Damn it.
I thought you lot were all spent.
Murderers.
They drove the bearers to this.
Wait. These two aren't turned.
That bitch of an innkeeper must have sent them. Colluding with the enemies of the Empire is a serious offense.
And for their crimes shall they be punished. Such is the law. To dwell in darkness that we may purge the night and welcome lasting dawn. On these our swords we swear.
How dare you speak those words? Have you no honor?
Clive.
This won't take long.
Is that all of them?
I think so. I didn't see the abbot. He may still be alive. The abbot.
The bearers died protecting him. Calling upon what little magic they had left in their bodies.
Clive, he's breathing.
Friends of Martha. We're here to help.
Are the Imperials dead?
They are. Every last one.
If only that were true. The Black Shields will return. Continue. Rosaria will never be saved unless we save her. Tell Martha to beg Sid's aid and tell her this wasn't her fault.
I shall.
Sid, where are you?
In here! We found a survivor!
Clive. He's gone.
We've laid the abbot to rest, but the bearers, they didn't need to die like this.
No, they didn't.
but it was their choice. They knew the fate that awaited them and chose to meet it on their terms, fighting for those who fought for them.
Martha said they rose from their beds, threw themselves at the Imperials so she and the Abbot could escape.
I've gathered the bearers' remains. We should consign them to the tide.
There's a drawbridge not far from here. Riddick's jump. The currents there are swift. If the Abbot were still with us, he'd have taken the dust there himself and performed the casting. I'll get someone to...
I'll do it.
Of course. Cole and I will remain here and see to the Imperials.
What am I saying? Of course it has. It's a floating eyeball. Nice try. Too slow. Nice try. Too slow. Too slow. See that coming. That must be the bridge. So shall the waters cleanse thee of thy burden, and bear it out to sea.
And now they are truly free.
I hope so. What of the Imperials?
A pyre was made. It's more than they deserve. We should go back. Cole is worried about Martha.
All right.
Good. Thank you, Founder. Thank you, Phoenix.
Oi, look sharp.
Hey, what?
I'm glad Martha's safe, both for her sake and the town's. This place wouldn't be the same without her.
And they call themselves our countrymen.
Thanks for heeding the call.
If only we'd got here sooner. We'll do what we can to help the injured, though.
Best off staying where we are for now, I reckon. The boys from the garrison might still be nearby.
I'd rather not bump into them.
We'll return to the hideaway as soon as we've finished our ministrations.
Arthur's a stout soul, all right. Anyone else would be out cold after what she's been through.
It's not fair, Sid. Death shouldn't be the only choice. The only way to be free of all this.
No one survived then.
I'm sorry. Before he passed, one of them bade me tell you not to blame yourself.
Doesn't mean I won't. Doesn't mean their blood's not on my hands. Cole said you cast their remains. That was good of you. But it should have been me. This was all my fault.
How? You couldn't have known.
But I did. And I turned a deaf ear to the warnings like the fool I am. The rumors started moons ago of black-clad devils descending on villages in the dead of night to slit the throats of sleeping bearers. But I assumed it was all just nonsense concocted by the Empire. Nothing but a ghost story meant to make folk think twice about lending a hand to a fugitive bearer.
And in ordinary times, you would have been right. What these black shields are doing is unthinkable. Which begs the question, why do it at all? My mother obviously has a hand in this. I cannot make sense of her actions.
And picking what goes on in that woman's head is a job for someone with more time on their hands. Right now, I need swords and men to wield them, preferably big ones. If those Imperials think they can come in here again and threaten my people, they're in for a rude awakening. Oh, before I forget, a Stolas from Otto landed just before you arrived. He asked me to tell you that Gav has returned.
Then we must as well. Will you be all right here, Martha?
We can stay longer if you wish.
No need. I'll be ready should the Imperials come calling. Though I wouldn't turn my nose up if you were to lend me a pair of them strapping young coastbreakers. Poor souls died to give me a chance to save others. I won't let their sacrifice be in vain.
Try not to move. You're already making worse.
I know. It's Martha who needs your attention, not me.
You there! Don't just pass me by! You handy with that sword of yours?
Of course you are.
Bet you're a bloody marvel with the thing. Now, question is, are you willing to use it or not? Because a flock of noble chocobos are in need of help.
Chocobos?
You heard me right. Wild birds? The big ones?
And not just any chocobos at that.
Whiteheart and her flock are the bravest birds you ever did see. They protect travellers round these parts from bandits and the like.
Chocobos. Fighting bandits.
It's true. Why, they saved me from a gang of footpads only yesterday. Nasty lot they were too. And now, they're back, looking to settle the score. Go on, then. Don't just stand there. Go and help him.
All right.
There's a good lad.
Where can I find these chocobos?
I saw him cut across the way over yonder. The rotten scoundrels were driving the poor things towards the old dock. It's a dead end, that is. You save Whiteheart and her flock, you hear me? There ain't a pluckier bird in all the world. She's a hero to us locals. And don't worry, you'll know her when you see her right enough.
I'm sure I will.
And good luck to you. And give those no-good bastards a hiding from me.
Soldiers from the garrison just stormed in unannounced and started smashing up the place.
We're not alone. You make it look easy.
A white feather. I thought Ambrosia was one of a kind. Speaking of brave birds. Looks like they went that way. These chocobos aren't going down without a fight.
We got you cornered, Feathers. You didn't think you'd seen the last of us, did you? You've been bad for business. But I reckon someone will pay good coin to mount your head on their wall.
Not around here, they won't.
And why's that, eh?
Because she's something of a hero in these parts. You hurt her, and I hurt you.
Piss off! Or better still, how about we hurt you both?
All right, then. But don't say I didn't warn you. Yeah.
Yeah.
You're safe now. White Heart, I presume. Do you know her, boy? That scar. It couldn't be. Ambrosia. It is you. You survived. And you found yourself a flock.
Oi! Is it over? I thought I'd come and see how you were getting on.
Oh, you sorted the bastards then. I knew you would.
And the whole flock made it through unscathed.
Thankfully, they did. And not only that.
Well, I'll be. I never stopped to think our hero here might once have been someone's mound. Though I dare say she'd suit a fine fellow like yourself. Reckon our feathered friend must have learned a thing or two from her master, kind-hearted warrior that you are. Bird like her would have cost a princely sum. You born a lord or something?
Well,
Oh, no, sorry, I didn't mean to pry. Don't matter who you are. You done right by me.
What is it, girl?
She wants her master back, I reckon. Told you. And it seems her pals agree.
Is that it? You want to come with me?
Well, bugger me if this ain't a heartwarming sight. The lads down the stables will be hearing about this tonight. Oh, stay right where you are. Doesn't she cut an handsome figure, eh?
She does indeed. How much do I owe you?
Ah, a few scraps of leather's the very least I owe, old Whiteheart. Oh, I'll be sad to see her go, of course. But she's earned her right to happiness and more besides. Don't you worry, we'll get along just fine without her. You hear that, Whiteheart? You've earned yourself some time off. You have fun traveling with your master now. You seem awful familiar now I get a proper look at you. That's it. When those chocobos swarmed my cart on the road, didn't you? No. No, that can't be right. That fellow was a bearer.
Must have been my double.
Oh, must have been, eh? Oh, that'll be the excitement getting to me, silly sod that I am. Pay me no mind. Anyhow, best be on my way. Good luck to the both of you.
You take care of your flock for now. I'll call you when I need you.
Gah!
Let's go.
Fly, Ambrosia.
Where's Gav?
Oh.
Well, did you find me some wax?
Find is one way of putting it.
Ugh. Reeks like a chocobo's arse. Well, I don't suppose the Argo will mind as long as he stays above the waves.
Argo? So your boat has a name? I didn't know.
Yeah. Same as me old man. He was a ferryman himself back before the blight came. The boat's all I have left of him. And thanks to you, he'll sail another day. Yeah, Sid. How is it I never see you on the ferry? Ah, forget I asked.
Depending on who you ask, this lake was either formed when one of the fallen cities plummeted from the sky, or when a giant worm dug a lair for itself.
My guilt is on the latter.
Gav should be back by now.
I hear there's trouble in Rosaria.
Martha's gonna get back on her feet. She'll need our help, whether she wants it or not.
Those men didn't hurt Martha, did they?
Well, don't just stand there gawping. Finished, are you?
I think it's all right to touch it.
No. You go first.
If you told me you could fire a forge without a crystal or a bearer before I came here...
What do you need? What do you want?
Clive! Oh, I've missed that scowl.
Where's my report?
What, no kind words for your old pal Gav?
If it's kind words you're after, you're fishing in the wrong barrel. Now sit down, you fool.
So, you remember how quick the Empire was to occupy the Dominion after the fall of Drake's Head? And how pissed off all the other nations were that they didn't think to do it first.
Half a century of independence gone at the whim of a madman. So much for their bloody treaty.
Clearly, the promise of unblighted land and the world supply of crystals was too much for his radiance to resist. And now the Republic's finally decided to follow suit, using liberation as an excuse to declare war on Sambrek. Lined up right outside the Dominion's gates as we speak, looking to starve the Imperials into submission.
And now all eyes are on the Strait of Ortha.
While the two nations beat their shields, the rest sharpen their daggers, ready to set upon the war-weary victor. They'll never see us coming. It's time we moved on the Mother Crystals. Four Mother Crystals remain in Storm and Ash. Drake's Breath, near Ironholm. Drake's Fang, in Dalmechia. Drake's Spine, in Walud. And Drake's Tail, here in the Crystalline Dominion.
With the bulk of the Republican army marching to Twinsight, Drake's Fang will be left exposed.
That is exactly the move Kupka would anticipate. And if there is anything these past 5 years have taught us, is that he loves his traps. There is one place, however, where nobody will be expecting us to go.
Drake's Breath.
There's a shitload of sea between us and it, and I've never been much of a swimmer.
I have an acquaintance in Port Isolde who may be able to help.
Who's that, then?
My uncle. Byron Rosfield.
Lord Byron Rosfield, of the Seven High Houses, the trade magnate with holdings in over 100 cities. Wait. Rosfield. And you're a Rosfield, of course.
My uncle's name gave him his start in the world, but it was his acumen which earned him his fortune. Along with a handsome fleet of ships.
Well, it's settled then. What are we waiting for, eh? Huh?
What are we waiting for, indeed?
You look like you could do with a drink.
Oh, you're not leaving already, are you?
Chocobo, why can't you fly? What good are your wings if you can't reach the sky? Flap harder, says Bluebird. Flap harder, says Crow. Flap harder or into the oven you go!
How much water can a flower drink?
About as much as a bothersome boy.
along now, Martell. They'll try your apple soon enough. See, I was hoping to speak to you.
Is everything all right?
Oh, yeah, it's just... Well, as you know, we've been trying to grow fruit down here.
It's good to know that something of the old hideaway still lives on.
Martell's pride and joy. It was a sapling when she rescued it from the rubble, but look at it now. All our hard work's finally paying off. I took it on, you see, after she... Well, after she died. And now the fruit's finally ready to eat. And not only is it ready, it's actually tasty. Sweet as you like, in fact. She bred the bitter right out of it.
Impressive. And welcome news to more than a few, I'd say.
I thought this first harvest could go to the Curse Breakers, on account of all they do for the hideaway. You couldn't take them some, could you? Seems better them coming from you.
It'll be nice being the bearer of good news for a change.
Oh, thank you. She always had a soft spot for that lot, see? And once they've had their share, I'll see to it that everyone else gets some. Here you go. Martell apples, they're called, in honor of her memory. You hear that, Martell? Today's finally the day.
Like a still.
It would explain Blackthorn's foul mood. All that pounding must be splitting his skull. And you say Sid built this place?
Well, one can't really build what's been lying around for several thousand years. But it was his idea we claim it for our own.
Perhaps they're old enough for the sins of Zemeckis.
Able to prime that night 5 years ago, despite there being no ether in the Deadlands.
says here that while conjuring magics requires a bearer to draw ether from the air around them, priming requires a dominant to draw it from their very self.
Go on. What's the matter, Sid? You look as pale as the day your predecessor slung you in the cell next to mine. Not about to have another fit, are you? Of course you are.
Dress is simply fabulous.
In it, though? All the ladies in the Dominion are wearing them.
There was a time I only had eyes for Otto, but then I saw the light, and his name is Cole. That way he looks at you like a frightened fawn who's lost his mother. Oh, if only I could shoot an arrow through his heart.
Once the Dalmechs have laid siege to the Dominion, very little will be leaving Twinside, including the many medicines distilled there.
So Mather's all right?
Yep. Others weren't so lucky, though.
You two look like you could use something to eat. Here, courtesy of Martell.
Martell. Now, where have I heard that name before?
Weren't she the girl from the Furrows?
Course she was. An odd sort, that one. Loved plants more than people.
Aye, and brave as a bane might. Remember when she ran back into the hideaway to collect them trees when Titan attacked?
Wait.
These aren't those apples, are they? Well, I'll be. She'd have been proud, and rightly so. Thank you, Sid. Them old apples were enough to curdle your guts. But these beauties are as sweet as you like.
I'll have to pay the boys down in the backyard a visit to tell them thanks.
A gift from the backyard. For your service.
These take me back. I haven't seen a hideaway apple since. Old Sid was the only one who could stomach the things. He'd nab them right from the branch, made Martell livid. Not that anyone could stay mad at the man for long.
That sounds like the Sid I knew, all right.
Planning on keeping that lot to yourselves, were you?
Hang on. These aren't Martells, are they?
I'm glad to see someone carried on what she started. Can't have been easy, not in the Deadlands. Reckon she'd be happy knowing all her hard work didn't go to waste. Clyde, tell the lad down in the backyard to run some over for me, will you?
Not so much as a thank you. Well, I've got some manners at least. Thanks, Sid. You can leave the basket with me. I'll see that the others get their share. Oh! And, give our compliments to the gardener, won't you?
That was the last of the apples. I should head to the backyard and pass along everyone's regards.
Can't remember the last time I had fresh fruit. Oh, I'm looking forward to this.
Doesn't sound like anywhere is safe. Not that I'm planning a journey.
Clive! Oh, same old. So, and Sid. But he's still with us too. Quick look. Always something in there.
Oh, Clive. Welcome to the Patron's Whisper.
The Patron's Whisper? Does that mean someone else is taking care of our friend's donations?
Oh, no. That's still me. It's just Karen has her toll, Blackthorn has his hammer. I thought a new name might liven things up. I still catalogue every item that arrives, in addition to setting aside those tokens of appreciation the sender has specified are to be presented to you personally. Would you like to see if we have any? Business is busy. Still. Words are immortal. Is everything we've received and everything promised. Here you are. You earned this. Come again. I may have more for you.
What's the matter, Nectar? The hunt board. It's where the Cursebreakers post sightings of particularly fearsome beasts. Those that might pose a threat to our operations if they were left to roam free. Just because they can't be dealt with when they're spotted, doesn't mean they can't be dealt with later. Was that what you wanted to know?
Thank you.
Right. Well, leaving your mightiness aside for the moment, the people of Alastia are going through a lot already, what with the Blight and the war. The last thing they need is ungodly fiends terrorizing them on top of everything else. So if the Cursebreakers are too busy to help, then perhaps I can. Or at least I can try. I don't think so.
And how may I assist you today?
How may I help you today?
Here you are. Here's the latest information I have. Very good.
Them old apples were enough to curdle your gut.
That room's as ragged as goat.
If you're worried about our supplies, we've plenty. Karen's seen to that. Though we're always one missed shipment away from disaster.
Your uncle always seemed a kindly soul, if a little eccentric.
By trade, but I've always been fascinated with the art of healing.
If only there were a salve to mend a broken engine.
How good it is to see you, Clive. I have a few new notes that might interest you. What subject shall we consider today? Did you learn everything you needed?
Everyone used to live in the sky.
I think it's all right to touch him.
Breakers send their thanks and their compliments. They were clearly very fond of Martell.
They remembered her after all these years. I suppose she was very kind, even to a tongue-tied lummox like me. You were one of the good ones, Martell. Why did you have to die? She put everything into her work. She wasn't going to rest until we had fruit sweet enough to enjoy. And now we do. When she died, I named a sapling after her. And now it's a full-grown tree. Martell lives on through the fruit it bears.
And through you. Her dream would have died with her, had you not kept it alive. That's something to be proud of.
I didn't do anything, really, but thank you. You're kinder to me than I deserve.
By the way, Otto's expecting some of your crop. And I wouldn't mind some of it either, if that's not too much to ask.
Of course not. I'll see that you're both well provided for. They like your fruit, Martell. Isn't that wonderful? I'd say it's about time we planted you some siblings, don't you think?
Do you think it was wise to leave Gav? He didn't seem pleased.
I needed his eyes and nose in Dalmechia. I'm not about to let Kupka take us unawares. Besides, he has a knack for that sort of thing.
That he does.
And wasn't it Cid who said that matters such as these are best left to Dominant? Especially should one of his beloved opportunities to grow and change present itself.
I always knew that I would return one day. Return to Ironhome.
For what?
After learning the truth, you were given the chance to face your past. If I am to continue at your side, I must do the same.
We'll face it together, then.
To the end.
Come on.
How far do you think your mother's reach extends? Will we find the same tragedy in the south as we did at Martha's Rest?
More than likely. Which is why we should hurry. There are still many settlements between here and Port Isolde. We visit as many as we can and hear their stories. Starting with the village of Amber. Let's go. Thanks, girl. Yeah.
come on.
Fly, Ambrosia.
Mockery of justice is what it is. Lord Elwyn would never have stood for this.
Quiet, you! Nothing but loyalists.
Jill, look.
Rosaria must be cleansed of the stain which befouls her, that she might rise once again from the ashes to welcome a new dawn. 'Twould be a pity to make examples of you all for the transgressions of but a handful.
Of course, your lordship. You shall have our full cooperation.
What business could the Black Shields have in a village this small? There's barely room to hide a bearer.
Then they must be here for something else.
You fancy dancing a gallows jig like the miller's son?
All right. I heard you the first time.
I ain't got much, but what's mine is yours, for a price. Much obliged. I suppose we won't be seeing you again. You're a long way from home, aren't you? Keep to the roads now.
Run along now, before one of the boys starts thinking you're something you're not.
Father.
I told you to stay in the house. Go on!
Word is, Port Isolde's closed her gates to all but the Highborn, and now a great camp sprung up along the walls.
Two more left to join the garrison this very morn.
At this rate, there'll be none left to help with the harvest.
Going hunting for outlaws. How'd you like that, boy?
There was a time my husband might have stood up to those men. Though back then, he wouldn't have needed to. There was a time my husband might have stood up to those men. Though back then, he wouldn't have needed to.
Excuse me. What was all that about earlier?
You haven't heard? Someone's been stirring up trouble. There have been attacks on the garrison, supplies stolen. They even say a Black Shield was murdered. The Empire wants answers, and what the Empire wants, Empire gets.
Don't they just?
Keep your ears open, eh? The Black Shields will pay good coin for information on the culprits. You'd have to be dull as a sack of stones to think you could take on the Empire. What with their 100 full legions?
100? I heard it were 1,000.
seen them, didn't you?
I'm sorry.
The black shields. Just now. You've seen them, didn't you? At least I think there was a black shield. Can't say I ever saw one before.
Was this the first time they visited the village?
What do you think? Amber's the arse end of nowhere. And they thought we might be harboring firebrands. Huh. If only we were. I might have turned them in and become a black shield myself.
You don't think these firebrands the Empire is looking for could be us, do you?
I don't know. How'd you get it? But we need to find out. Greetings, friend. We are travelers.
I know that. What do you want?
We couldn't help noticing those Imperial soldiers who were here earlier.
Don't you go telling these strangers a thing. I speak for the people of this village, and we have nothing more to say to you. You are to leave Amber and never come back.
May I at least ask why?
I don't know who you are or what brings you here, but your presence puts us all in grave danger. The Empire is a harsh master. Its demands are great, and its justice swift. But as long as we keep our heads down and pay our tributes, we are left alone. Some might call it submission. But if it will spare my people the Viceroy's wrath, then I will gladly submit. This village will not become another East Pole.
Then we shall be on our way. These people live with a knife to their throat. In the mistaken belief that if they cooperate, my mother will show them mercy.
Obedience bought with fear.
Are you all right?
Sorry, it's nothing. We still don't know who the Black Shields are looking for.
Well, whoever they are, the Imperials deem them worth pursuing to the back of beyond. But other than Martha, who else in Rosari would have the courage to stand against the Empire? A new ally would certainly be welcome. Can we find them before the Imperials do? Perhaps the next village will yield more answers.
Perhaps.
Let's go.
Faster!
This pass will take us through the mountains.
And directly into the path of whoever or whatever lurks here.
Ever since the Apollo Tree, we've seen more and more of these echoes.
What do you think is waking you? The Mother Crystal's collapse.
I have an idea. You're not going to like it.
To me, boy!
Farewell.
Let's go. Ready, go?
This might take a while.
Blood, Clive.
And still wet.
You were told to stay in your homes.
The Black Shields.
You know who we are. And still, you would bear your steel. Why then? We owe you our thanks. You have saved us the trouble of an interrogation. To dwell in darkness, that we may purge the night and welcome lasting dawn. On these, our swords we swear.
Say that again. I'll show you a true Fraternian. Tell me what I want, and the end will be swift. Who are you looking for?
Why, you. We come bearing a message. Your friends have been found. The branded you freed from our camps. They await you in Ordeal. Guardians of the Flame.
Those are Old Hill's gates.
Then we hurry. Find something, boy. Death.
Found her.
Thank you.
This was my mother's doing.
But why? Why would anyone...
I don't know. I never truly understood her. But this...
Oh, Clive.
I will learn what madness drives her, and I will end it. We should go.
Yes.
We can't leave them here like this.
We won't. But if the Black Shields have made it this far south, they may already be in Port Isolde.
We're approaching Bewit Bridge. Though I doubt the Empire would let us cross over to Rosalith.
To come by way of Oldhill, did you? Saw some Imperials clad in black making for the docks just the other day. The next morn, you couldn't see the sun for all the ravens.
Tell us there's a curfew, but then refuse us passage back to our homes.
They're all Rosarian.
But this is their home.
How am I to sell my wares if they won't let us into the capital?
Pass
passage to the provincial capital is restricted to Imperial Army personnel.
The gates are closed. Be gone!
I'm hungry.
You'll find no succor to the south, travelers, nor beyond the Buet. The Empire has seen fit to banish us from our own land.
Don't go thinking you'll find refuge in the houses outside Port Isolde. The place is a wretched hive of thieves and blackguards.
Ready, go?
All right. You deserve a rest.
You're finished.
The Lazarus. What happened to this place?
My mother happened. The nobles who lived here didn't stand a chance. Let's hope my uncle fared better.
We should stop
the main gate and see where that gets us.
Ambrosia.
That's the main gate. And it looks like we're not the only ones hoping to get in.
Them pilgers nice and chill.
Look at this place.
Good girl. You deserve a rest.
Help me, boy. Yeah.
hurt, Torkoal.
That's it.
Rest well. I know I will.
I hear there's trouble.
I think it's all right to touch him.
Autumn's breath, ill tidings born, an erstwhile home in twain are torn. Now in his path fell shades of eye, pray let them not impede his
all right.
Yep.
Without a ship to carry you there, Drake's breath might as well be on the moon.
Fancy a look at the list, do you? Quick look. Think you can help?
Help you today, Clive. Come again. I may have more for you.
Doesn't sound like anything.
Yeah.
Thank you.
know there aren't any more of them.
Chance of slipping through unnoticed. We'll need to find another way in.
I thought we might be able to reason with the guards. Or at least bribe them.
I suspect everyone in that crowd thought the same. Was that the only way in?
Officially, yes. Strictly speaking, no. My uncle once told me that the nobles had tunnels built so that they could visit town without having to walk amongst the rabble. The Lazarus. We'll find our way into the city there.
If you're sure. The entire place looked abandoned. Do you think it's safe?
As long as it is abandoned.
The good news is we haven't seen a single black shield since Aldhill.
Maybe they found who they were looking for.
To that gate of Rosarian. They've sold their souls for the promise of a warm bed. Not that I can blame them. The Empire's left us nothing.
Why won't you
open
let us in?
The dark gates!
Not a step closer!
You'd leave us to the wolves!
Yeah, maybe they'd shut you up.
This is nothing like I remember it.
How quickly a crown can lose its luster.
Oh.
Not abandoned, then.
Oi! Visitors!
Apologies. We'll show ourselves out.
I've only ever seen one man fight like that. And he's long dead.
Then perhaps it's time you joined him.
The blessing of the Phoenix. It can't be. I was there when you died. Forgive me, my lord. I knew not whom I addressed. You have naught to fear from us. Founder, it really is you.
It is. So wait.
We can speak inside.
And those who wouldn't bend the knee?
We left before the Empire could make examples of us, though we didn't go far. And we banded together to form the Guardians of the Flame soon after. Alas, there is only so much a handful of aging shields can do against the might of an empire. But we've seen to it that their stay has been anything but pleasant. Of late, though, we've had our hands full just trying to keep the Duchy's few remaining bearers out of the Imperial's clutches.
The Cullings. We saw what happened in Old Hill.
Aye. The foul work of the Black Shields and their mistress.
You mean my mother? But it doesn't make sense. Even knowing what I know about her. Her hatred for bearers was no secret, but she wouldn't have been ignorant of their value to the realm.
No offense, my lord, but in case you haven't noticed, the Lady Annabella couldn't care less about the realm. She barely even cares for her own home. That much has been plain since the slaughter at Eastpool. And since granting the Holy Emperor a new heir, her obsession with bearers only seems to have grown. As to why, I don't know. Maybe she can't bear the thought of anyone having the power to challenge her beloved son.
Her son.
Sir Wade, the Black Shields are broken camp. They march in full force for Bewick Bridge.
Then so do we.
Make ready.
The
This is their main host. If we remove the head, perhaps... perhaps we can prevent what happened at the docks from happening somewhere else. If I do nothing, then the blood of their next victims will be on my hands.
Yours and ours. We too have witnessed the crimes these men who dare call themselves Shields have committed in my mother's name. It cannot be allowed to continue. We must put a stop to this madness.
We must. So let us go with you. For the good of Rosaria.
I was hoping you'd say that. Very well. If that is your wish, I would be honored to serve at your side.
And we at yours.
So, Wade, let us do our duty.
With pleasure, my lord.
I imagine this endeavor will require more than just our wits.
Then let's hope Sir Wade has a good quartermaster.
I suppose we owe you our thanks. At least you're not. You dead. Spared us when you could have just as easily sent us to the mud.
We'll show them that the fire in our hearts is not so easily quenched.
The Black Shields won't know what hit them.
You're telling me that's the Archduke's son?
In the flesh.
We'll show them as much mercy as they did our sisters and brothers in Old Hill.
Less if I have my way.
You are welcome to what little we have managed to salvage. Will that be all? I will be here should you need aught else.
Tell us then, Sir Wade. What is your plan?
Nothing fancy. You, Lady Jill, and I make for Buett Bridge and provoke the main host at their encampment. Sensing an opportunity to end the Guardians, the Black Shields will call for reinforcements, who will be met from the rear by parties of my brothers hidden throughout the surrounding hills. This will allow us to wage battle on the bridge without fear of being overwhelmed. While the Black Shields have an advantage in numbers, you see, they prefer to fight in small units, which we can use to our advantage.
How small exactly?
Small enough, now that I have you and Lady Jill for company. I doubt I could have done this on my own.
But until we arrived, that was your plan. You haven't changed a bit.
Sir Wade, the bearers from Old Hill have been laid to rest.
Very good. Now make ready for battle.
As you command.
Thank you, Sir Wade. Perhaps now they will find peace.
There is but one thing which will grant them peace. Putting an end to the Black Shields.
And so we shall.
blessing of the Phoenix go with you.
How long have you been pursuing the Black Shields?
Since they burned their first village. We tracked down the bastards responsible and fed their corpses to Stillwind. Suffice to say, that got their attention. It's been a game of cat and mouse ever since.
Fly, Ambrosia. Sideways. How was the Black Shields?
Come along now.
The bastards are lucky I didn't have my axe.
There they are. On your command, my lord.
What is it now? I told you!
We bear a message for the Vicerine. From the Guardians of the Flame.
Ha! You presume to tell us that a pair of filthy vagabonds, a woman and a dog, could guard aught against the might of the Black Shields? Then come! Die along with your flame! For Azaria!
For Azaria!
Your petty revolution ends here. On these our swords, we swear.
Waken wind!
Bloody hell!
Reinforcements from the far bank!
Another one to fight their battles for them.
All yours, Torgal! Torgal, kill!
chances. I can't say I'm flattered.
A noble stand, albeit a misguided one. In taking it, you have but proven our point, that this land is in dire need of cleansing.
I don't see any more.
Nor do I. The plan worked.
It did. It bloody worked. We sent every last one of the rotten bastards straight to the mud! My, Lord. Perhaps this will be enough to stop the Cullings. For the time being, at least.
Perhaps. Though I doubt my mother will take this loss well. She'll move swiftly to see her minions' ranks replenished.
And then it will all begin again. I often wonder if the nation we once knew is gone for good. Her fields rot. Her people starve. We battled to preserve the flame that was, but for every foe we fell, another springs up in its place. Yet be that as it may, it is still our home, and we must fight for it. As we always have, and always will. For as long as the Firebird's flame burns in our hearts, the Duchy cannot die. And her loyal subjects may dream of a day when the Rosarian standard flies over Rosalith once more.
So Wade,
Think we should fall back to Porter's Alder before the garrison sends reinforcements? A sound strategy, my lord.
And how long has my uncle been funding you and your comrades' endeavors?
Since the beginning. Lord Byron was the first person I turned to after forming the Guardians. And had I known of this tunnel back then, I wouldn't almost have been hanged by the city guard for trying to sneak over the wall.
I suppose a formal request for an audience would have appeared suspicious.
And appearances must be maintained. Were the Vice Regency to catch wind of Lord Byron's involvement in our movement, they'd seize his estate and send him to the gallows, where he would be of no use to anyone. And so, though it sickens him to the soul, he plays the part of the loyal lord, knowing that one wrong move might prove his downfall. It is why he remains ever vigilant. Don't be surprised if he refuses you an audience, especially since you're famously dead.
Then I will have to think of a way to prove that I am neither wraith nor wrongdoer.
I might have something which could help with the latter. It's the mark of the Guardians. Display it, and those who love Rosaria will know where your loyalties lie.
I shall wear it with pride.
Be sure that you do. I don't want my men attacking you again. Unless you deserve it. If only Sir Tyler could have been here to see you. Or the Lord Commander.
Thank you, Sir Wade. If there is ever anything you need.
I know. Go on now, my lord.
How accommodating. Do you really think they believe we are who we say we are?
Not a chance. All right, I guess. My uncle believes we're imposters here to rob him. And means to string us up himself.
Imagine my surprise when I was told my nephew had come to visit. Clive Rosfield died long ago. And for uttering his name here, you shall pay with your tongue! You would mock me as well.
It is I, Sir Crandall of Camelot, loyal servant to Her Serene Holiness, Saint Sybil the Unshod. Meadow, thou vile sorcerer, for thy crimes against church and crown, I shall have thy head.
Curse thee, infectious flax wench. even in death, must thou plague me still? Very well. I shall open the gates of hell, that thou might see thy charge once more.
Bravo, uncle. You're still the finest madu in the twins.
Oh, Clive, my dear boy, it's really you. You always were fond of that scene from The Saint at the Sanctuary. Never did let me play Sir Crandall.
I have a favor to ask, Uncle Byron.
Rutherford, inform the kitchens. There'll be guests. We dine immediately.
But, Uncle...
You can't very well regale me with the tale of your miraculous preservation on an empty stomach. Go on, sit. See that you use the good plates, Rutherford.
So you arrived late to one of her cullings, did you? Since becoming Vicerine, Annabella has been a constant thorn in Rosaria's side, but these atrocities are a new low. Something has changed. Quite what? I don't know, but the woman we knew is gone, and a monster sits in her place.
A monster?
For better or worse, I've been charged with governing this town, and thus must maintain the illusion of obedience. That's all I can do to aid Wade and his merry band of revolutionaries.
So he's told us. You have risked much for Rosaria. Our nation will be forever in your debt.
It has been 20 years, Clive. The nation your father and your forefathers fought to defend is no more. Perhaps it would be otherwise had I the courage of my brother. All right, if it's a ship you require, a ship you shall have. I've a galley in port, but recently relieved of her cargo. She can be outfitted for the voyage in a matter of weeks.
So you believe us, then? About everything?
Believe you? Ha! Only a fool would believe even half of the things you claim. But until tonight, only a fool would have believed my nephew still lived. And besides, I have it on good authority that Clive is telling the truth.
Whose authority?
By your own, of course. You've always been a terrible liar.
Is that true?
It's not untrue.
Let's say no more about it, eh? It wouldn't do to linger on my nephew's greatest failing. The one thing I cannot believe, though, is all this about you being Sid. You were always such a good boy. But now you're quite the outlaw. Which, if I'm not mistaken, would make me an outlaw's uncle. Right then, who shall we pillage first? Rutherford, fetch me my cutlass. This will be fun.
She's a fine ship, isn't she?
Once outfitted, she'll bear us across the boiling sea to Drustinus in the space of 3 days.
Something on your mind?
Monsters. When I served the Iron Kingdom, I did so because I saw no other choice. Because once they learned that Lash would not move me, they turned it on those who could. And so I became their puppet. I let them pull my strings, telling myself it was not my hand that swung the sword, but another's. I removed myself from the truth so I wouldn't feel the pain it caused. And before I knew it, I no longer felt anything. Anything at all. I had become a monster.
Jill.
I don't want to be a monster, Clive. Do you understand? I want to choose a different path, a better path. To live on my own terms. But before I can do that, I need to come to terms with my past.
And when you do, I'll be standing there with you, just as you stood with me.
Thank you, Clive. I must atone for my sins. Only then, when it's done, will the monster cease to be.
Just promise me that you won't die with it. Now, let's get some sleep. The journey back to Benamir is long, and there is much to tell the others.
Founder knows what awaits us in the Iron Kingdom, but Vivian could probably make an educated guess.
Thing to happen to Hideaway since, well, ever. She's got a smile like sunshine, and she can pull an ale like no other.
That monster's taken quite a liking to Lady Karen.
He's not a monster, he's Targal. And he'd take a liking to you too if you gave him as many nuts as Nan does.
And what can I do for you? Go on then.
Is that all?
Sangfornian, do you? That it? Fine.
I didn't take you for a scholarly van.
Oh, this? It's Valisthea, a culinary pilgrimage. I borrowed it from old tomes. Seems there's no creature in the realm so foul it can't be cooked up into something delicious.
Think I'll stick to the unfoul ones, thanks.
Oh, where's your sense of adventure, Sid? Honestly, one glance at these recipes, and even you would trade in your sword for a butcher's cleaver. From spit roasts to sweetmeats, this book has them all. What I wouldn't give to bring these recipes to life.
If it's my blessing you're hoping for, then by all means.
Well, I'm no hunter, Sid. The first tunnel worm I came across would be the death of me. But you're made of sterner stuff. Would you help me resurrect one of these recipes?
Something tells me you won't be taking no for an answer. Fine, I'll help.
Fantastic! Thank you.
So, dare I ask what's on the menu?
Chance's stew. It was once a favourite among the gourmands of Oriflam, if the author is to be believed. Though Molly's never heard of it. The only problem is that while the recipe is extremely detailed in most respects, it's infuriatingly cryptic as to the main ingredient. A beast, no doubt. Most likely something that would make easy work of a simple cook with more broth than brawn, but unwanted violets. I've no idea what they might be.
Does the book say anything else?
Well, only that the sweetest violets sprout atop the bed of roses.
Roses? Rosaria, perhaps? One of the butchers in Martha's Rest might know something. I'll ask next time I'm there.
Nothing but unwanted violets will do if I'm to resurrect this stew. As to what they might be, as you say, that is a question for a butcher.
Sid, because you can't have this one till we've finished.
She's taken quite a liking to Lady Cara.
He's not a monster.
Sing a song of six gil, a bag of phoenix down. A pigeon from the rear deck boiled in Molly's brown.
Can bring succor, and they can bring death. It all depends on the flower. Which is why you shouldn't go eating them unless you know what you're doing.
This
tun here pulls the black from the lake water and renders it full.
You'll have to ask the medic if you don't know.
Confusing. I'm lost half of the time.
I'd take that over being found by the constables any day. Little Shirley has grown into a fine woman. She's taught me that none of us are too old to learn.
Did you even read it? I filled the whole page, just like you said.
I said fill it with words, not scribblings of Moogles.
Young Mid wouldn't want us snooping down there. She calls it her dungeon to scare the children away.
So, that's how Hugo Kupka was able to prime that night 5 years ago. Despite there being no...
Visit another mother crystal. How, did I hear you ask? Some habits die hard, I suppose. But don't worry. We're all on the same side now.
The water in the lake is far too foul for drinking. Fortunately, our friends in the backyard have solved the riddle of how to draw the black from it.
Sid, come to look out over the lake?
There's many a man and maid who'd gladly welcome young Cole down there to their beds. Me? I only have eyes for goat. Now, there's a man I could get behind, though I'd rather have him behind me.
That book, do you think you might read it to me?
A journey by sea can be just as dangerous as one over land. Make sure you've plenty of pickled greens on hand, or you'll be bleeding from your gums before the iron blood have swung a club in earnest.
Go.
Seen enough?
Oh, I wasn't expecting you back so soon. Your benefactors are a generous lot. all yours. Come again. I may have more for you.
There are new billets being posted every day, but not enough swords to see to them.
How did we never hear about these Guardians of the Flame?
Same way they never heard about us, I expect.
A part of me thought Drake's head might be the last crystal we ever cracked, but I'm glad I was wrong.
Typical nobles, cowering behind their walls rather than joining the fight.
A sea voyage this time, is it? I can lend you an oilskin if you're looking to keep the salt off your back.
I could have sworn we had a few more.
Be over soon. One way or another.
Depending on who you ask, this lake was either formed when one of the fallen cities plummeted from the sky, or when a giant worm dug a lair for itself. My guilt is on the latter.
Finish with that log so we can call it a morning.
Wouldn't be half as bad without all the bloody dust. Ha 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 ha.